Hi students, welcome back to my class. And today we are going to go into the explanation of the poem Mr. Nobody. Let us begin. Mr. Nobody, I know a funny little man as quiet as a mouse. So let me first explain you the literal meanings of little words and phrases, and then part by part we are going to read it again so that it makes sense and you understand in totality. So it says, I know a funny little man. So here little man means a child. Okay. Why funny? Because this little man does funny things around the house. Okay. So I know a funny little man as quiet as a mouse. That means this little man, this little child is as quiet as a mouse. A mouse, when a mouse moves from one place to another within your house, do you get to hear the mouse? Not really, because mouse is usually very quick and very quiet. And a mouse always makes mischief around the house. Okay? So this little man has been compared to the mouse or the quietness of the mouse. Okay? So this means this little man, this child is also as quiet as a mouse. Here the mouse, here as quiet as a mouse means extremely quiet or docile. Okay? Who does the mischief that is done in everybody's house? So, this little man is as quiet as a mouse, and who does the mischief that is done? Mischief means all the naughty things that one does, that a child does inside a house, or that sometimes even you do in the house. That is what this little man does. But where? In everybody's house. Okay? Not in your house, not just in your house, or not just in my house, but in everybody's house. There's no one ever sees his face. Okay? So there's no one ever who has seen his face. This little mouse, this little man's face has never been seen. And yet means but still, we all agree. Okay, that means we all. This poem is talking to us all. It's as if it is speaking from us, from our side to others. This is a poem of all of us that we all can relate to. Okay, which is why it is talking in terms of we all agree. Okay, it could have said they all agree or he agrees, but no, it is speaking in first person. It is speaking as if it is speaking for us as well. Okay, so and yet we all agree, that means we all accept, we all agree that every plate we break was cracked. Every plate we break was cracked by Mr. Nobody. Okay? So that means this stanza very clearly says a few things. That the poet who is anonymous, that means unknown, This unknown poet knows a funny little man or a child who is as quiet as a mouse, who does not make any noise before making any kind of mischief. Okay? Who does the mischief that is done in everybody's house. This little man does mischief in everybody's house. And there is no one ever sees his face. There is no one who has ever seen his face. So nobody knows what this person looks like. And yet we all agree, even if we have not seen this person, but we all agree that every plate we break, that every plate that I, you or anybody else breaks in the house was cracked by whom? By Mr. Nobody. Okay? So now you understand that all the mischiefs that are done in everybody's house are done by whom? By Mr. Nobody. Even if we are the ones who have cracked the plates, even then, it is not us who should be blamed. It should be Mr. Nobody who has to be blamed. And we all agree to that. That means we all put the blame on, I don't know, it should I. It was not me. I did not break that plate. Then who broke that plate? I don't know. Mr. Nobody broke that plate. Okay. So, this is what happens in all of our houses. Or most of our houses. Okay. Now let's come to the second paragraph. 'Tis he who always tears our books. 'Tis he who always tears out books. 'Tis here means, in old English, dear students, in old English, it is was written as 'tis. Okay, there's an apostrophe as you can see, and then there's T-I-S. So this actually means it is. Okay, it is. Tis he who always tears out books. So now they are talking about books, tearing of books. As you can see here, there's someone who has torn a page or pages out of books. Okay. So it is he, it is that Mr. Nobody itself who tears out books, who leaves the door ajar. Okay. Here, you can see this refers to this. Leaving the door ajar means who keeps the door open. You can see to keep the door open partially. You can see the meaning here. Okay. It is he. So what did we learn? That there are already two things or three things that Mr. Nobody has already done. Every plate has been broken by him. It is he who always tears out books. And it is he who also leaves the door ajar, who leaves the door open. Even when it is told that you should not keep the door open, even then it is this little man who keeps the door open, door ajar. He pulls the buttons from our shirts. Here, pulls the buttons from our shirts means, sometimes you will see that even in your school shirts, okay, sometimes the button can get loose or somebody can pull it off and then that shirt gets spoiled. So sometimes Mr. Nobody also pulls the buttons from our shirts. Okay, actually it might have been us who mistakenly pulled it out, but it was actually Mr. Nobody who had pulled the buttons from our shirts. That squeaking door, and scatters pins afar. Okay, you know what are pins? Pins look like, you know, a pointed pin that is there, And a pin is very dangerous in nature. You should not be scattering pins everywhere. See, you can see here. You should not be scattering pins everywhere because it's very dangerous. It can prick your leg. It can prick your pets. Right? But Mr. Nobody scatters pins afar. Afar here means far away, at a distance. That means when you scatter something, if you scatter the pins, if you throw the pins mistakenly, then it gets scattered everywhere. It moves around everywhere. Right? It does not fall in one distinct spot, but it scatters afar. That squeaking door will always squeak. Okay. Here the word squeak means to make a high-pitched sound. So have you noticed, students, when a door is very old or if it has rained a lot and a door needs to be lubricated, if there's some rusting that has happened, sometimes the door makes noises, sometimes in horror movies this sound is often used to express that something is very ghostly in the house. Okay, so that sound is of a squeaking door. So in all of our houses, when there's a squeaking door, usually somebody is asked to actually put oil to that door so that it stops making that sound, so that it stops squeaking. But it is Mr. Nobody who does not do anything about that squeaking door, which is why the squeaking door will always squeak. It will never stop squeaking. Why? Because nobody is going to look into that. Mr. Nobody especially is not going to solve this problem. That squeaking door will always squeak. For prithi, don't you see? So students, here the word prithi actually means please. Okay, this is a word that was actually predominantly used in old English. Okay, so just like we have modern English, there was also olden English. There's also the form of English that Shakespeare used to speak in or write in, right? So in olden English, prithi basically means pray thee. Okay, thee means me. Okay, pray for me or please. So here it means please. Okay, so now let's look into the sentence. That squeaking door will always squeak for prithi, that means for please, don't you see? Can't you see? We leave the oiling to be done by Mr. Nobody. Oiling means to lubricate something with oil. So to make the squeaking door stop from squeaking, what do we need to do? We need to oil it so that it stops. But we, of course, are not going to do it. Why? Because we leave that work of oiling to be done by whom? None other than but by Mr. Nobody. Okay? So you can understand, students, that this Mr. Nobody is actually nobody else but us. Okay, so how many tasks have been referred in this poem already in these two paragraphs? Today we are going to read only until these two paragraphs. Okay, let us go through it once again. First, I am going to identify along with you what are the mischievous things that are already going around in the house. Okay, first is, every plate we break was cracked by Mr. Nobody. Okay, it is he who always tears out books, right? So Mr. Nobody tears out books. Who leaves the door ajar? So this is another point. He pulls the buttons, from our shirts. That is another mischief. And scatters pins afar. So scattering of pins is again another dangerous mischief. And then the squeaking dough will always squeak. Why? Because the oiling has been, we leave the oiling to be done by Mr. Nobody. Okay. So, they are basically 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 mischiefs that we do that we blame on Mr. Nobody. Okay. So let me read through again, students, this part. Now I hope you are going to remember. You have to also remember the word meanings. I have written them down, some of them down beside the words itself, so that it becomes a bit easier for you to remember what this means. Okay. Also remember the glossary that is there. Okay. Okay. Now I'm going to read. I know a funny little man, as quiet as a mouse, who does the mischief that is done in everybody's house. Now you can understand, students, why this has been expressed in this way. Why has Mr. Nobody been compared with a mouse? Because all of these mischiefs are done silently, without coming in front of others, or without doing it in front of others. All of these are mischiefs that we do on our own in our homes, either by mistake or sometimes just because we want to. Okay. Who does the mischief that is done in everybody's house? There's no one ever sees his face. We can never say that we have seen that person who has broken the plate or left the door ajar or done all of the mischiefs. We can never say who has actually done it. So we have never seen this person's face. And yet we all agree that every plate we break was cracked by Mr. Nobody. So the word "we break" is very important, okay? 'Tis he who always tears out books, who leaves the door ajar. He pulls the buttons from our shirts and scatters pins afar. So here, see again, it is said, he pulls the buttons from our shirts. So it is he who always does all of this. Okay? It is not us, it is him. That squeaking door will always squeak. For prithee, don't you see? For please, don't you see? We leave the oiling to be done. That means the oiling of the doors, okay? To be done by Mr. Nobody. Okay, students? This is it for today. And we are going to see each other in the next class, where we are going to go through the rest of the explanation. Thank you.